Well, hello again, Buck fans, and it's time for our first softball Buccaneer update of the season. We're joined by head coach Shane Winkler of the Charleston Southern softball team. His team gets started this weekend at the Palmetto State Showdown in Columbia. Before we talk about the tournament, coach, team overall has a very solid outlook going into the year. You guys were picked fourth in the Big South Conference, and I know you're very excited about the year that's coming up.
Oh, very excited. We got a great group of returners. We return eight, but we got nine newcomers coming in that are challenging for spots also. So I believe we have probably the most talented team that Charleston Southern has fielded in the history of the program. Very excited.
Before we talk about those nine newcomers, let's talk about some of the returners, the pitching staff led by Sandra Vetter. She had a solid year for you guys last year, went 12-12, and I know you're expecting big things out of her again in 2010.
Very much so. Sandra returns. Had a solid season, but she plagued by injuries last year, so we're looking forward to a healthy Sandra Vetter this year, which is going to be very much improved.
A pair of Megans lead the way from the offensive standpoint. Megan Hall was your leading hitter last year. Megan Lombard slugged five home runs, and I know you're expecting even better seasons out of them coming up.
If you look at us in the preseason so far, both of them have improved a great deal, which is very exciting for us. Megan hit over 330 last year, Megan Hall. She's added a little power to her bat this year. She's got one home run in her career. I look for her to challenge her home run record this year, which is eight. Both Megans have the ability to do that. As you said, Megan Lombard had five home runs last year. She's probably our most consistent hitter right now, and I look for both of them to challenge anyone in the Big South offensively.
You mentioned nine newcomers. That's a lot for any squad, but especially for softball, more than half of your team. Talk about some of those newcomers that you expect to make instant impacts and how you plan on working them into your regular lineup.
Well, two of our newcomers came in January. Treya Steele and Shayla Colum were both mid-semester transfers for us. Both of them are in our starting lineup. Treya is going to be playing second base for us. Slick fielding infielder has made an immediate impact. We'll use her bat as well. Shayla Colum is a junior transfer from Campbell, was a freshman All-Atlantic Sun Conference player for them. So we look for her to make an immediate impact at third base. We'll also see some time at first base. So those are newcomers that came in that semester that we really weren't looking forward to having when the fall season was upon us. But Jessica Brock has showed a very big bat for us. Jana Matthews led us in home runs in the fall. She's a freshman. We'll see some time in right field. And then Courtney Connick, Mandy Camargo, both outfielders, slappers, add a lot of speed to our lineup, which we didn't have last season. Same thing with Jasmine Conley. Freshman who will see some time in the outfield. When she's not in the starting lineup, she's going to go ahead and pinch run for us. Kimby Hobbs, a junior college pitcher. So not all of our newcomers are freshmen. So we've got a junior college pitcher. She's seen some great competition in the junior college level for Georgia Perimeter. Look for her to make a big impact as well.
Yeah, it's always big when some of those newcomers can be from the JUCO ranks and they're already experienced playing collegiate softball. Now let's talk a little bit about this weekend. You guys are at the Palmetto State Showdown in Columbia. Talk a little bit about the competition and what you hope to accomplish this weekend.
Very, very exciting preseason tournament. You take all the top Division I programs from the state of South Carolina, and basically it's your South Carolina State Championship.
Sure.
So it's for us, we're going in with the expectations that we can challenge with anybody in the state. Obviously it's being hosted by an SEC program in South Carolina. Great facility. As well as anyone else in the SEC, that you're going to play in a great facility there. We're going to see USC Upstate first. They return a very solid pitcher in Morgan Childers, so we've competed with her last year. Furman, also Lana Mackey, is a very good pitcher. So we'll see two teams on the very first day who are going to be solid in the circle, but teams that we've competed with in the past and look to be successful this time around.
And the schedule doesn't get too much easier once that tournament's over. I know you guys take on Dayton, Louisville, several other good clubs before you even get to your Big South schedule. So it's going to take a solid effort from you guys this season to improve upon last year, but something that you're definitely expecting to do.
Exactly. We put together this schedule, one, because we want to compete against the best. We're facing Georgia, who finished third in the country last year. Louisville's coming in our place. They're in the top 25. We got a lot of other programs from major conferences. And basically that's to prepare us, yes, to go ahead and compete with the Big South, but our goal as a program is to make it in the NCAA play. And by competing against teams that are going to be in the NCAA tournament, it puts us in a position to where we'd have to been there, done that type thing when we finally reach that goal.
Yeah, and picked fourth in the Big South Conference. Definitely plan on contending for a Big South championship. Coach Shane Winkler, best of luck this season. I'm sure we'll talk to you plenty more before the year's over.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, that's head softball coach Shane Winkler. Like we said, his club gets started this weekend at the Palmetto State Showdown. For Coach Winkler, I'm Rob Walden. We'll see you next time right here on the Buccaneer Update.